The Reuters news agency reports that the 17-month U.S. effort to train and build up the Iraqi army has fallen short. Current and former U.S. officers and officials told Reuters that despite U.S. efforts, the army's combat capacity has barely improved and that the government relies too heavily on Shiite militias to do the fighting. For more about the readiness of the Iraqi army, I'm joined via Skype by Ned Parker of Reuters, who co-wrote the report. For someone watching at home, give us a little bit of a lay of the land here. What's the mix between the Iraqi army and the militias? Who's doing most of the fighting?
Well, it's a mixed bag, really. The problem is that the Iraqi army only has about five functioning divisions, according to U.S. officers. And those divisions are at about 60 to 65% capacity. So on the ground now, when fighting happens, the Iraqi military has basically a shortage of labor, and the one good fighting force that's there that's effective from the state is the Iraqi Special Forces. And according to U.S. officers, those forces are in real danger of burning out because they are the only force that the state has been able to rely upon time and time again over the last 2 years. So the other force fighting alongside the Special Forces are militia groups that many of them are funded by Iran. They have hardline sectarian ideology and have been deeply controversial. So on the ground, what happens is in many places, like north of Baghdad, in areas like Tikrit or Beji that were retaken from the Islamic State by the Iraqi Special Forces, as soon as the battle is over, in effect, the militias take over. Mm-hmm. And the people in these areas, whether local officials, ordinary citizens, see not the state, but the militia forces as the ultimate power.
In part of your story, you also talk about the supply chain and that it's not all getting to the Iraqi army. Sometimes that the weapons that the United States is sending is actually getting to these militias.
What has happened is that as supplies go down the chain to big depots such as Taji, mm-hmm. which is the largest weapons warehouse for the Iraqi military in Iraq, on bases like that, if militias have influence, whether through corruption or just intimidation, they can take what they want. Now, U.S. officers I've spoken to say that there was a huge effort last summer to tamp down on this and to stop it, and there are very few cases, but it still continues.
And so what's the U.S. supposed to do in this?
Some officers say that the Americans are not thinking about this enough and aren't doing enough politically to push the deal. And when you speak with U.S. military spokesmen, they'll say, our job is not to police Iraq. Mm-hmm. And the military track moves far faster than the diplomatic track. But then if the military track is shaping a reality on the ground that is only further antagonizing and pushing Sunnis towards perhaps a new radical force mm-hmm. that could emerge after the Islamic State, then that's a problem because the political solution is so far behind. The new realities are creating new problems.
Ned Parker of Reuters joining us. Thanks so much.
Thank you.